Well, the Santa Ana winds are kicking, leaving us nothing but clear skies over Dodger Stadium in L.A. Today, a matchup of division rivals at opposite ends of the standings between the San Francisco Giants and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Major League Baseball on MLB Network is next. Kenta Maeda will do the pitching in Game 3 of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, Kenta Maeda, you're going to see a lot of off-speed pitches from Maeda. 88 to 91 miles an hour, not a terrific fastball, good split finger, good slider. He's one of those guys that pitches backwards. What do I mean by that, Matt? He'll throw fastballs in breaking ball situations, and he'll throw off-speed pitches when he's behind in the count, 2-0 or 2-1, he pitches backwards.
So in now for San Francisco, Kevin Pillar. And the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. Here's a high pop up. And Freese will put this away, no problem for the first out. And here's how the visiting San Francisco Giants line up in this one. Dan, who do we keep an eye on?
Yeah, this lineup is really looking for a change of fortune from Pablo Sandoval. Talk about struggling. He had less than 5 hits the entire last month. Whoa, like, that's like a hit a week. I mean, come on. When you wake up and fall out of bed, you're at least going to be able to get 1 hit a week. He has to do a lot better than that.
Next to bat for the Giants, Brandon Belt, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number 2. Dero, Danny, this L.A. Dodger ball club, as they enter play here this afternoon, they come into this one in decent form, as despite the loss last time out, they've won 6 of their last 9.
Yeah, Matty V, and you know one thing you don't want to do here, D-Row, you've been on some good teams, not to lose focus at this point of the year and keep the big picture in sight, because there is a postseason lurking, and it's so easy to get ahead of yourselves and not take the rest of the schedule serious.
I think the nice thing for this team is that they won the division. They will, for whatever happens, get a 5-game series. It's not that 1-game wild card, win or go home. This team can prepare themselves to battle and try and win 3 out of 5.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number 2. Here's the second baseman, Scooter Gennett, and there you see his righty-lefty splits and how they've played out so far this season. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Just underway here in Southern California. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And we'll flip it on to first, and with it, that ends the inning. Giants are down 1-2-3. Nothing for the Giants in their first try. The Dodgers' first swings are next. You're watching MLB Network. Jeff Samardzija gets the assignment for the rubber match in this series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Well, Jeff Samardzija, the pride and joy of Valparaiso High School, Valparaiso, Indiana. Also a pretty good wide receiver for the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. Big, strong guy. A lot of people think he takes that football mentality out on the mound. 94 to 96, good sink, good late run. Good hard breaking ball, and his split finger has gotten a lot better. If Jeff Samardzija is on, you'll know early he'll be inducing a lot of ground balls.
Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number 1. Time now to check out how the hometown Dodgers line up in this one. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Well, I know they're just waiting for Jock Peterson to come alive. In the last 10 games, he's hitting under 250. He's a guy they need to hit a lot better than that, because he's a big part of this ball club.
Here's David Fries to stand in. In 8 at-bats in the series, he's collected 3 hits. The 1-1. Heading out towards shallow right. Pilar's there, and he makes the catch for the second out. So that'll bring in the National League rookie home run record holder Cody Bellinger. He enters play in the hunt for the league's home run crown, but he'll have some work to do down the stretch. Two out, nobody on. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
That's a well-placed fastball right there, just off the outside. If you can get guys to expand the strike zone and go after that pitch, you're going to have a lot of success. No luck that time, though.
Ball. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
2-2.
Samardzija gets the sign. He'll try to put him away here on 2-2. Popped up. Sandoval on the move. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Dodgers down in order. We are still scoreless. Now the Giants' number 4 batter, Chris Shaw. He'll lead things off against Kenta Maeda. The 1-1 home. Taken, strike 2.
The count is 1-2.
And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. Hard hit ball to second. And a reach to his backhand side at second, but this finds a way by.
Hey, guys, he was obviously trying to bury that slider down and in. Nice execution by the batter right there, keeping his hands inside and fighting it off for a nice base hit.
Into the box, number 5. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
All right, guys, here's the defensive alignment for the Los Angeles Dodgers. And let's focus our attention on infielder third baseman David Fries. We all know the history. One of the most dramatic home runs in St. Louis Cardinal history. This guy doesn't get enough credit for being a very reliable defender. Look for him to make a big play today.
So a runner on first with one out now. And standing in now, the versatile Pablo Sandoval. The 1-1. Lined hard toward right center. And Sandoval's aboard, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second, as there are 2 aboard now.
A lot of traffic hitting a base pass first and second with one out. I know you're looking for a double play ball, Dan.
No question about it. I think one of the things you like to do on a pitcher is try to jump on him early before he gets settled in. So far, so good. First and second. Looks like a big inning could be brewing.
Now batting, Buster Posey. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. The 1-1. Heading out towards shallow right. Bellinger's under it. 2 down. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with 2 away now. the shortstop, Brandon Crawford, took an 0 for 4 in the victory last night. Shaw at second, Sandoval at first, two out in the inning. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1. And here's a pitch taken by Crawford for a ball, 3-1.
Interesting sequence of pitches right there. A real ugly swing on a ball away, and it looks like the batter has a much better idea of what he's looking for after that second pitch.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Taylor is there. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Giants leave a couple. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. And next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter, Max Muncy. He's a long ball threat, of course, currently number 4 in the National League home run race.
Hey, D-Ro, this is one of the elite power hitters in all of baseball. Only a half a dozen home runs, though, last month.
Yeah, half a dozen, but times it out by 6 months and you're throwing up 36 big boys. I'll take that in a full season.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Danny, D-Ro, this Giants team, as they begin play here this afternoon, they were finally able to snap that long losing streak last time out. A rare bright spot in what's been a horribly difficult stretch.
Hey, thanks, Matty. Hey, you know what, D-Ro? Try to get on a kind of a little mini winning streak here. Losing the first game of this series, winning game two, and hopefully winning this series by pulling one out here today.
Yeah, Dan, they were able to shower that first loss off in the first game of this series and had a nice bounce back game yesterday. Let's see if they can steal a series right here.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Time for a look at the San Francisco Giants on defense. And this team, they're not going to be moving around as much as some of the new age teams. The shifting and moving the third baseman over second base and the right fielder to play third base. This is going to be your stationary team, trusting pitchers to execute pitches.
Here's Jock Peterson now, and he's a guy really in need of something to click at the plate right now. It's been a rough go for him. Bottom of the second here with no score. Called strike, and he's behind 1-2. Chin high, that's taken for a ball. Pulled toward right center field. Shaw on the move. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. Next for the Dodgers, Chris Taylor. 4 hits already in the series through 7 at-bats. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. We'll move to the third with no score. And now the Giants pitcher, Jeff Samardzija. And you see that average below the dreaded Mendoza line. And now a pitch on the way. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Taylor is there. Makes the play, one away. And with one away, time for a quick check of the standings, and it'll show you that these guys had the division race all sewn up as they look forward to baseball in October. Stepping in, Kevin Pillar. Third inning, no score to this point. 1-2. Pop straight up. Number 9 takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out. Here's the first baseman, Brandon Belt. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit down the line at first, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. The 1-2. He pulls this one into right. Bellinger is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Giants down in order. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Next up for Los Angeles, number 16, 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. Six up, six down. We'll see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with the bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty, but hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
2-2 to the Dodgers catcher. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Standing in, number 9. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. The 2-1 pitch. Slow roller down the third baseline. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Dodgers have yet to break into the hit column here. He's running. Popped up. Just foul. The 2-2 one more time is looked at, and the count moves full. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone. So you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
Next, the hit will be the pitcher, Kenta Maeda. A fairly clear sacrifice situation here with two on and nobody out. Now the 1-1 pitch. Is a bunt attempt, but he can't get any wood on it.
That's not great form right there, but you can't be surprised. A lot of these guys were not asked to bunt coming up through the minor leagues, so don't expect every sack bunt to get down.
It's bunted into the air, and the catch is made for the first out of the inning. Back to the top of the order now. And up next, the former All-Star shortstop, Corey Seager. The 3-2 pitch. This is on the ground over to first. One there. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. A couple of walks, but no damage. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Striding in, Scooter Gennett. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out. So with that, let's call on the guys in the graphics department to put up the pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And both of these guys have shown a decent fastball. Each has touched 93 so far on the gun. So one away here with the bases empty. And digging in at the plate will be Chris Shaw. Come on, Dodgers. The 1-2. Popped high in the air. And he'll squeeze this one for the second out. Now at the plate, number 5. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number 4. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. To the bottom of inning number 4 we go. And we are tied 0-0. Riding in once again, David Fries comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Line to the right side. That's a hit, the first in this game for the Dodgers. Now at the plate, Cody Bellinger. He popped out in his first trip.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
And he fouls this one off. Sent out to straightaway center field. Shaw is after it. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. One gone now in the Dodger fourth, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitter Max Muncy. They'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now. Well, if you love pitching and defense, this has been a game for you. Are you happy with that, Dan?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
The count now at 2-2. No runs, just one hit. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. There's a ball ripped toward the gap in left center. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double.
The good news for pitchers in this park is that it doesn't give up many home runs. A lot of room in the outfield. Sometimes that's the bad news as well, though, because there's a lot of space for hits to get down and to go for extra bases just like that.
Oh. And it looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk, and the force play is now in order. So it's bases loaded, one away, and in to hit next, it'll be the ever versatile Chris Taylor. Ready with the 1-1. High in the air down the right field line. On the move is Pilar. And he makes the catch in the corner. Now a long throw home. And he will score on the sacrifice fly as he's in with our first tally of the ballgame.
This has pretty much been a pitcher's duel so far. So any way you can score a run in a sac fly right there brings home the first run of the game here in the middle innings.
Standing in, number 16. Two men on, two away here in the fourth. One and one. Here it is. Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it. For the current campaign, number 16 is below the Mendoza line. The batting average under 200, unfortunately.
Matty, he struggled against right-handed pitching all season long, but he just needs a few knocks today, maybe to get the confidence going. I don't think this is a norm for this ball player.
Here's the 1-2. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
All right, 3-2 count with two outs. The runner on first will be moving, so we'll see what happens. There are a lot of possible outcomes with this kind of play.
There's a swing and a high, deep drive headed for the right field corner. And it'll fade just at the end and winds up a long foul ball. Here's the payoff pitch. Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. In to score is the runner from first. It's a 3-0 game.
Usually a hitter will shorten his swing with two outs, but not this guy. He puts a big charge into this one and drives in a couple of runs along the way. That can be frustrating as a pitcher when you had a guy on the ropes and you couldn't finish him off, especially when he drives in runs.
In now, number 9. Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. So 3 runs on 3 hits, no errors and a man left. We played 4 full. Dodgers out in front, 3-0. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. Between innings, I was able to discuss the current state of the Giants lineup with manager Bruce Bochy, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Ready now, Pablo Sandoval, who started out here for San Francisco with Buster Posey to follow on deck. The 1-1. This is line to left. That's in another base hit. He's 2-for-2. So a good start to the inning for the Giants. Leadoff hitters aboard.
Take a look at this again in slow motion. He tracks this thing all the way, gets his hands quickly through the zone, and just rips it down the left field line, just how they draw it up.
Here's Buster Posey now. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Away! the 2-1. Line drive to left. Peterson is there and he makes the catch for the out. So a runner at first with one man gone, and stepping in the slick fielding shortstop Brandon Crawford. Here it comes on 1-1. 1-1 pitch is a circle change. It hits the target 1-2. Two balls and two strikes to Crawford.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
And Crawford swings and misses at that one. A strikeout victim for out number two. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And up next, the former Notre Dame wide receiver, Jeff Samardzija. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. A ball and two strikes to the Giants pitcher. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Working for the punch out and the offering. Pitch popped up. Number 9 is under it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. One hit, one left. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Dodgers 3 and the Giants nothing. Andrew Tolles will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. In there, 1-2 now. Still 1-2. The 1-2 misses for the second ball. Right field and deep. Look at this thing go. And it's gone as they add still another. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His first home run of the season as the Dodgers have increased their lead now 4-0.
Hey, that's one of the toughest parts about standing out there on the bump, giving up a long home run or giving up a bomb at any time. As a pitcher, you just have to regroup and get back on that horse.
Into the box now, Corey Seager. Lifted down the line in left. And that will end up a foul ball. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
This is why it's so hard to be successful as a hitter when you fall behind in the count. 1-2, you're probably expecting some sort of off-speed pitches, but when the pitcher offers up a good, hard fastball, it's pretty hard to adjust and catch up to it.
Stepping in now, David Freese. He loses him on ball 4.
And you can tell by his body language that he's beyond frustrated by that call. He's got to be wondering what he's got to do, but the last thing he needs to do is to let it get under his skin. That will only make things worse.
Now here comes Bruce Bochy out of the Giants dugout on his way to the mound. And he'll signal for the bullpen. That's going to be it for Jeff Samardzija. So he'll make his way to the dugout after working just 4 1/3, and he just didn't have his best stuff in this one. Tyler Beede enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Cody Bellinger will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. The 1-1 home. Hit hard up the middle, and that finds its way through for a base hit. And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy. He's 1 for 2 in this one. Freeze on second. Bellinger at first, one gone. Into the corner and slicing foul. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Just inside, not by much. It's 2-2.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood and a broken bat.
Fouled away. First and second now, one man out. You can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
Just tied him up with that last pitch. Pretty evident by the swing. Sometimes guys get in that protect mode so much that they're swinging at everything that they see, and they end up offering at pitches that they can't possibly do anything with.
Into the box, Jock Peterson. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball.
Come on, Dodger!
Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. Lays off the changeup, and he's ahead in the count now, 3-1. Is in there for a full count now, 3-2. 4 runs, 5 hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Curveball, but a good job to lay off, and he works out the free pass.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk him to load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
Into the box for the Dodgers now, Chris Taylor. He'll try to do damage with the bases loaded and two gone. Yeah. Changeup, called a strike, and he comes back even at 2-2. Good. Fouled off. Two out, bases loaded. Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been, as they'll strand the bases loaded. The side is retired. But the Dodgers add on courtesy of this solo home run. 5 innings complete. It's now 4-0 L.A. Number 85 is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief.
Count
And now back to the leadoff spot in the Giants lineup. Stepping forward, Kevin Pillar. No hits to this point.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going. And the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Digging in, Brandon Belt. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Throw gets him, two down. Scooter Gennett. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Liner toward right center. Bellinger is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Giants are down 1-2-3. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. Now to the plate, number 16. He drove in two with a double in his last at-bat.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
The 1-2 is laid off for ball two. The 2-2 gets him looking up around the letters. So stepping in, number 9. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Bases are empty, one man out. Hit on the ground out to short. Throw in time at first for out number 2. Number 45 will get the call to pinch hit here, as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
Pretty standard curve in the dirt, looking for a strikeout there, but that was a good job of recognizing it and holding back at the plate.
Two out, nobody on. Just missed with the 2-2 count, and it runs full now.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
The 3-2 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Shaw has a read on it. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Dodgers down in order, but they're in front 4-0. Back here at Dodger Stadium. The men in blue leading in this one as we get set to begin the seventh. But before we do, let's check out the game summary to this point. Casey Sadler is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. Chris Shaw, the next to take a turn at the plate. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far.
starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
The 2-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
One out, nobody on. That one doesn't even sniff the zone, missing very high. Hung that one out there a bit, but it's a called strike, 2-2.
We're seeing quite a few pitches up from him right now, and that can obviously be dangerous. A called strike there, but he might need to lower his sights a little bit.
Changeup taken for ball three, well below the zone. There's the Panda on deck. He'll bat next. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Coming to the plate now, Pablo Sandoval. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. Oh, and he hammers it to deep right field. And this one is gone, a home run. A solo shot here for Pablo Sandoval. His first home run of the season. As they get on the board, it's 4-1 now.
Well, they're still down, but this homer right there might light a fire under the whole team. Give them a spark to climb back into this thing. We'll see if this gets them going.
In now, Buster Posey. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Some action in the Dodger bullpen now as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. Bases are empty here with two men out. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that they'll end the inning. So it may be too little too late, but they're on the board here in the late going. Get up and stretch. Home half of the seventh coming up. It's the Dodgers 4 and the Giants 1. Here's Corey Seager. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7, 8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball.
It looked like, from our perspective, he gave up on that one a little too quick and then tried to emergency hack late.
Lifted the other way down the left field line. And he will make the running catch here deep into the corner. Not an easy play by any stretch, and that's the first out. Ready for another shot now. David Freese. He enters this at bat, 1-for-2 with a walk. We're in the seventh now. 4-1 our score to this point. Two pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Shaw moves over. He's got it, and there are two down now. In now, Cody Bellinger. It was a single for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a solid one hit in your entire career. But pressure's off now. Maybe he gets hot.
Two out, nobody on. And it's fouled away.
Hey, great job just to be able to foul that one off. In today's game, that's what we're seeing, north-south. Pitchers want to elevate, want to get you out above the zone or below it.
And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers, but they lead it 4-1. Dylan Floro has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Now at the plate, Brandon Crawford, 0-for-2 for him to this point. The 1-1. Freeze with it over at third. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. Well, the Dodgers have enjoyed the upper hand so far against the rival Giants as you get a look at our line score through the first seven innings from Dodger Stadium. Number eight will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1.
Hey, let's not sugarcoat this. This is a huge half inning right here. They have to find a way to score a few runs. They do not want to face the closer needing three runs in the ninth. That means game over.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Eighth inning, 4-1 is our score. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
And there's out number two. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Kevin Pillar. Two away here in the eighth, and time's running out on him, Danny.
Yeah, and they don't have a lot of outs left to work with, so it's time for someone to make something happen if they're going to get back into this thing.
High in the air down the right field line. Bellinger's under it. And he hauls it down in the corner. Giants down in order. And this is still a 4-1 ball game. Tony Watson is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. It'll be the four-hole hitter, Max Muncy. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Here we go. smoked the other way, high and deep to left. Well, he's going to haul this one in on the run as he winds up just shy of the wall for the first down. Digging in to try it again, Jock Peterson. It was a walk in his last trip. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And he fouls this one off. Bases are empty. One man out. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. Sandoval has it. Throw on to first will get him. Score it 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. So striding forward now, Chris Taylor. Been a strikeout victim twice in this one. Two and one. Here it is. Grounded down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. All right, Los Angeles. He stays alive, still 2-2. Here now the 2-2. On the line, that's a base hit. Cutting it close here, but he comes through in the eighth to extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he was staring at his last at bat right there, probably his last at bat. Would have been tough to get him another AB in this one, but he's able to get it done.
Hey, better late than never. And I'm sure when he walked into that batter's box right there, he's thinking, this very well could be my last AB of this game. So if I'm going to keep this streak alive, going to have to do it right now.
Into the box now, number 16. Even count, two balls and two strikes. The 2-2 doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Full count with two outs now. So if he could put the ball in the gap somewhere, he could have a good shot of driving in a run because the runner at first will be in motion.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. And a good at bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with the man in scoring position.
Digging in, number 9, his previous battles with Tony Watson. He's 0 for 4. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. And another foul ball. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Popped him up. Belt moving to his left. And that ends the inning. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and two men left on. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Dodgers 4 and the Giants 1. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Kenley Jansen comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. At the plate, Brandon Belt. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once.
Tough task ahead here as this guy, one of the top save guys in the league right now. He's been very reliable shutting the door.
And it misses, 3-1 now.
If you're at the plate in this situation, you're only thinking one thing, and that is get on base. You got three balls. It has to be perfect over those 17 inches for you to pull a trigger. A walk is as good as a knock right here.
The 3-1 pitch. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a liner. Taylor is right there, one down. So the leadoff man gone to start the top of the ninth as we take a look at league saves leaders entering play. And as you can see there, he finds himself in a flat-footed tie for the National League lead in that category. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Scooter Gennett. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. The 1-2 out in front as he rolls over it to second, and an off balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. So here's the cleanup hitter, Chris Shaw. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Last strike here for the Giants. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Well, folks, that's what Kenley Jansen does. When he enters the game, the hopes of the other team, they usually just leave. Slams the door again right here.
And the score finishes 4-1 today. The Dodgers win for the 96th time, most in the division. Kenta Maeda gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Kenley Jansen records the save, his 47th of the campaign. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.